B Colonel. Kinda bored, got fuck all to do. Might go on another wander around, where to go though. Kinda lost. Might have a gander at the cathedral, say hello to them sisters and see if they need some help from me and my boys. All we've been doing is firing exercises and trying not to die to bugs. Walking can be kinda boring, but hey, it's nice once in a while. Also, we have no tanks. The order to the Munitorum hasn't come back yet. I assume they haven't seen it at all. Bucocracy's a bitch vox. Finally finish my walk to the cathedral. Really nice building. Haven't seen many built this way. Pretty nice, fancy and all. Looking around and don't see any sisters. The fuck did they go? Mustache. Time to go look around inside, they might be praying or something. Got a bad feeling about the sound, scared. Pull out LAS pistol and chainsaw just in case. Hear some gunshots and see what look like guardsmen fighting against. Wait, what the fuck? Why? Why are they shooting at a space marine? Are these boys fucked or something? Well, might as well help the big dude out. Start firing my pistol at these what I assume are traitors. Rev the chainsaw and charge at them as well. For the Emperor. Faith in the Emperor. Be me, Hakron, Alpha Legion guy. You don't know me, or maybe you do. Requesting a status update from the Control Master. Turns out the Blood for the Blood Ravens were outed too early at the checkpoint and had to forcefully enter the compound. Have them activate their Cornet's directive once they are in charging range of the Canonus. They won't expect guardsmen to have chain swords. Next up is the sniper. He's shot a fake commissar double that he set up. Those two are too smart for their own good. The Bane Blade has driven off and the sniper is following along the buildings. After that is the Zealot bodyguard, who is currently still undercover. Once he gets close to the bishop, he will go nuts. Finally the tech priest. He has completely disappeared. Very strange. My headhunters have set an ambush and melter bombs for those Primaris marines. They also want the Night Lord to help them. Think that is absolutely a fantastic idea, and send them along with more melters and stasis bombs, also some things that Night Lords like to play with. Also give them two extra directives. First, capture as many Primaris as you can, and get them back to base. Reverse engineering them will be of great use to us. And second, get that sword. It needs reforging and renaming. I definitely could use a new knife. The ship will be ready in 28 hours. More than enough time to mess shit up. Betugwell, last of the Night Lords, 83rd. Meeting with some alphas. Apparently we're going after some bastard marines. The Emperor never wanted us. Vindication. Okay, I get behind this. The bigger they are, the bigger the chinks in the armor. You want them alive? Define alive. Be me, Dratha. Be the last crasher, the problem child. Be pretty bummed out. I'm at the pile now, looking down at the remains of the biggins. Can see where the bolt rounds pierced their plate, where the chainswords cut their hide. That's rough, buddy. MP3. The hunger in the back of my mind is still there. The anger is too, but for now, just pretty sad. Look back over towards the furnace, where already most of the dead have been thrown into a fiery oblivion. I guess I should get going. Still need to find a place to rest. Look back over to the pile. Gaze stops on one figure. He's laying beneath some broken bits, so I go brush them off of him. Don't recognize the marine, but then, I really only knew the gut. Pretty much just as horrific as all the others, big and burly with power. But he's wearing something that draws my attention. Spiked collar around his throat. Seems pretty ordinary, yet at the same time, it radiates with something I just can't describe. Reach out towards it, feel the hunger rise up, as if in alarm. Shake my head, try to clear my thoughts, as I grab at the collar. Feel like the presence in the back of my mind is screaming at me now, calling me back, calling me away. I don't stop, I rip the collar off of the corpse, holding it in my hands. Way too big for me to wear around my neck. But, idea.gif. Uncoil the metal banding. Start to wrap it around my waist. Feel the screaming voices telling me to stop, telling me to throw it into the fire. I don't listen. I'm not a part of this family. Attach the collar around my waist, a new spiky belt. Drop to my knees, feel like fire is stabbing into me from my new accessory. Oh god, it burns. MP3. Scream, vision going black. Don't know how long passes before I wake up. But I'm up. Eyes open. Feeling better than I've felt in a while. Let out a sigh. Realize something. The hunger, it's gone. Like, I can't feel the presence anymore. Nobody's watching me MP3. Smile. Laugh. Absolutely amazing. I'm free. Be the exceptional rogue trader Corazon. Melt another guardsman face with plasma as he pops up to fire. Not entirely sure what it is I've been roped into. They're wearing the livery of the Blood Ravens, a Space Marine chapter. Not sure why men of regular size would be dressed as such, let alone attacking the cathedral. They did warn this planet made too little sense to be worth the trouble. But Asensio Corazon is not scared away by a mere dozen alien hostile armies. Or even a few hostile human ones. The local bishop's transmissions warned of gene stealer infestation, perhaps that explains these traitorous dogs. In fairness, I would make an excellent gene stealer. There are quite a few little boys and girls across the Imperium, and perhaps one or two in Xenos space, that owe me their existence. But I do not find the prospect especially appealing. The traitor guard in the rear turn around suddenly in surprise. Lasgun shots start hitting them from outside the doors. Ah, assistance has arrived. A torrent of pale mustachioed guardsmen in red coats and pith helmets run screaming into the hall with bayonets affixed. The rest of the traitor guard try to well around, but it is too late. Brother Salvador and I share glances. What a strange corner of the Imperium this is. But I am not one to look a gift horse in the mouth. Bimenkor cat, lost and incredibly frustrated lich good. Pull myself out of the organic's guts, stomping on what remains of its head as I walk away. Find myself at a dead end, inwardly curse the fact that I'm not a canoptic wraith and capable of passing through solid surfaces. Begin to turn around to find another path when I hear muffled shouting coming from beyond the wall. The sound of heavy footsteps running in the opposite direction follows the yelling. I've had enough of this place. Time for some stress relief. Use my bulk to crash through the shoddily made wall, surprising some female organics on the other side. Wait, shit, that's more organics than I thought there was, and they're all really well armed for primitives. Still, Menkor Cat ain't no coward, my mother raised me better than that. Mommy's boy. Love you mama. Angrily blurt yellow garbled mix of death comes for you and get off my lawn while shaking my fist. Turn and crash through another wall feeling a little better. That should spook them enough to get them to fuck off. Now, I'm sure my lord had a private ship hidden around here in case he needed to get off world. Beskar. The Gene Stealer. A lot of hobo brood brothers are dead, but I obtained a sister of battle to infect. Don't exactly know where. Maybe a survivor of that previous fight? Memory on that is fuzzy. Something burning comes from the other infected sister, the Palatine Sarah. It's golden and it fucking hurts. Forced to sever connection to her. Damn it, I'll need to get close to her to re-establish that. Still, the infection is still in her. She's just been severed from the brood. Weird.jpg, feel a burning sensation from the problem child. This one is very red, and very angry. Again, forced to sever connection. Damn it. Well, at least I still have this other sister of battle. Still have no idea where she came from. Where did I get this chick confused? Dodging a lot of people while moving through the sewers. Space Marines, sisters of battle, a few orcs. Even some TAU. Where did the TAU come from? Doesn't matter. When I encounter any groups that are small and isolated, I pounce and infect them. Gotta replace all the low quality kids I lost with newer high quality kids. Why the hell would they send everyone into tunnels that they know for a fact are filled with Gene Stealer cultists anyways? I mean, they had no problem setting the entire planet on fire a few months ago. Don't know why they just don't seal the exits and fill this place with burning promethium. Oh look, a lost and alone guardsman, shitting his band. Hey kid, would you like some candy? I don't have any, but welcome to the family anyways. B Colonel. Good thing I called in for backup for this. These traitors are hard going. Pretty entrenched, so it's gonna be hard pushing through. But hey, at least I can help the big guy. Oh, he has a friend. The guy he's protecting has some very fancy clothes on. Must some rich fop from Terra. Won't judge, just doing my job. Mustache. Clearing this out isn't too bad now that we've surprised them. What do they call it? Hammer and anvil or whatever high command likes. I don't know. Anyway, we're almost done here, just a few more to get rid of. Tally ho lads. Glorious charge. Bit hungry now that I think of it. Could go for a sandwich, or a scone. Anyway, now that these two have been relieved, I'll let my boys rest and get ready to move back to base camp. Let's talk to this Marine and his friend about where these sisters are. Not going to give up on why I was here in the first place. Be me, Sybarite Drazza. Be alone again. Winged Monkey scattered the squad. Destroyed the useless Venom. Wandering the various battlefields. Looting as much as I can. Find several containing my kin. Even a fucking Arcan. Definitely loot his shit. Find a nice fur cloak too. Also find a few with the craft world whelps in the mix. Loot a bunch of soul stones off them. Score. Rolling in cash. Hippox. Managed to find a working jet bike. Craft world standard but still usable. Start the thing up and head north. Just want to put as much distance between me and that thing as possible. Not to mention all the Jenna Stealers. Fuck Jenna Stealers. Pull cloak tighter around me to ward off the cold. Maybe I'll find someone to talk to. Laugh at my own joke. Befessus. So it turns out we couldn't reach Morgenson. Okay, that's fine. And that those weird guardsmen we confiscated the equipment from earlier are suddenly rebelling. That's not fine. I don't know what happened. It's a switch was slipped and they started fighting everyone. Fighting erupted at guard HQ. Shit, this is bad. Here there's fighting all around in the city. Some of it's from Jenna Stealers, others from traitor guard dresses as blood ravens. Shite. They're totally gonna blame us for it. Shit, what do we do? We have to clear our names. Wait, if we show them that the blood ravens have nothing to do with this traitor guard, maybe they won't kick us out, try to kill us again. Genius. Go around, pick some of our favorite guard boys. Give them some of the blood raven armor and weapons we confiscated. They're one of the rave guard now. What? Oh, what do you mean that name's already taken? All load up in chimeras. Head into the city to go show those wannabes what for. Run into a few parties of those assholes fighting the loyal guard boys. Gun them down with our superior ravens. Once we get the normal guard boys to stop shooting at us, they're actually pretty happy, if confused. No need to thank USE, just doing our duty. Head over to the cathedral with our boys ready to kick some ass and save the day. It turns out they've already got it handled. Oh, well, that's disappointing. Also, what the fuck? A guy goes to work and that's when you all decide to reach the climax and go ham with the posting? Also, seriously, would it have killed you guys to give at least a slight shout out? I'm not asking to be made the center of attention, but at least a mention of being present for the subplot I tried to build up involvement in would be nice. At least so I could have somewhere to jump back in from. Be Scar. Be the Jenna Stealer. Ro. Okay, that psychic gestation speed up thing is now working on its own now. We have like 100 first generation hybrids now, all fully grown. In other news, the humans are now all fighting each other. Yay. Happy bug. Don't have the problem child or that sharp shooting sister of battle anymore though. Not yay. Sad bug. I do have this other sister I've infected though. She seems a bit young and inexperienced. She's really into the family. It's like her devotion switch got changed from emperor to the family. She's great. Number one best girl. Painting that swelly monster symbol on her armor and everything. Making her father proud. Tears in my eyes. I hear through the brood connection grapevine that something big will be happening near the cathedral. I tell Ultrasius infected sister to go let a bunch of hobo brood brothers up there. Try to drag back as many good potential new family members as possible. She early nods and gathers up her brothers and sisters. As she leaves, I go down to some holes where we have a lot of the pregnant brood sisters hiding out. Time to do some warpy magic. Wanna see how far I can take the super gestation aging thing. Time to get radical. Be Tugwell, last night Lord of the 83rd. So, we just wait for them to come to us? All the alphas look at me. They all nod. Okay. Keeps me out of danger. Corridor wall falls down. Some massive Xenos automata just walks right in. Melter bombs go off. By the Primarch, that thing is still standing. Well, at least its arm fell off. It just put the arm back on. Hey guys, I think I'm going to look for loyalists over here. Be Palatine Barbastella. A kilometer or two into our retreat, I feel Palatine Sarah stirring on my shoulder. I signal the sepulchre to hold, and prop her up against the wall. She comes to fitfully, looking around at the ongoing battle blearily before voiding her stomach. She locks eyes with me through my helmet. It's clear she knows exactly what's happened to her. I had foolishly hoped that we would be free of the Undercity by now, but it's been a struggle to break through. Perhaps we could have sought the aid of the Ermine Mantleson had we reached the surface, but we cannot keep the Gene Stealer's minions at bay while also watching the Palatine in case she turns. Ending it now would be a mercy. Even through my helmet, she can tell what I'm thinking. She'd be thinking the same were the situation reversed, no doubt. Yet she holds up her hand to wait, and reaches for her belt. My grip on my saber saw tightens, expecting some trick, some implanted instruction the gene stealer would give to protect its brood. And then my eyes widen as I see her take out a vial of the Emperor's tears, draining it dry. Let it never be said that the Emperor does not provide. Regardless, it is too early to rejoice. Faith is no excuse for a lack of diligence. It would be too much of a risk to allow her command without confirmation that the tears do indeed live up to their reputation. Help Palatine Sarah to her feet, and continue moving as fast as we can to the decontamination station at the entrance to the tunnels. The way becomes easier as we put distance between ourselves and where I can only presume the nest is. The brood appears, distracted. As if something has shaken their insidious shared mind. Something to ponder at a later time. When we reach Hospital Adalia's checkpoint, I note the bolt-ridden corpses surrounding it. Some military, some ecclesiastical, some civilian. As she begins our blood tests, I inquire about them, the contaminated. Vectors seeking to spread their pox by sabotaging our tools. Gene stealers are canny foes indeed. And especially foul. To my relief, all of the survivors are clear of infection. We live to die another day. Bephesus. So apparently everything was dealt with, just like that, no sweat. Nothing big, or really worrying. No super grand plan for us to daringly and heroically foil. Just a bunch of dead traitor guard and a whole lot of everyone. Apparently an entire guard regiment, some space marines, a rogues trader, some more space marines, the Sikoff sisters and the commissars and their banner blade were more than enough to handle it. Well great, I feel let down. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love not being in danger or dying, and being a guardsman, we're usually the first get put in danger or die. But come on, we never get to do anything cool, whatever, least we're all alive, can't complain about that. Well, since the chances to be big damned heroes are all gone, might as well just go home. Wait, what the fuck are Thos? Oh shit, Jenna Steelers. And a fuck ton of them too. They're all being led by what presumably used to be a sister of battle who is now screaming about the four-armed emperor. Nope. Avi. Marcus, put your pedal to the metal and get us out of here. Let's leave this to the people who are heavily armed and probably too important to die. Some of them detach and start chasing us. Of fucking course they are. Unfortunately for them, we've got a lot more guys with us now. And you know what they say about Lasgans. One Lasgan does diddly squat. 50 Lasgans does a hell of a lot. Gun them down through the side ports of the Chimera. But more just keep incoming. Some try and pop up ahead of us to stop us. Apparently they don't realize that pedestrian laws only. It's not murder if it's a filthy xeno.ha. Still though, there's a lot of the chasing us. No matter how many we gun down, they just keep coming. Don't they have anything better to go after than a bunch of guardsmen? Be Palatine Sarah. Feel like I got hit by a rhino. Lost the small hope I had for a one and done cure. Can feel the tears of the Emperor and the gene transfer seed battling it out in my gut. Have to stop to throw up some slimy green muck a few times. It's unpleasant to say the least. But I can run. Make my way out with the Sisters of the Black Sepulchre. Barbastella gave me my guns back. Take shots at cultists, but I actually miss a few of them. Never a good sign. Notice that the gene stealers that get near me tend to shy away. Figure that pouring anathema to the warp into someone connected to their hiver mind might be something they find unpleasant. Good, we're even. Or will be, when that bug that infected me meet the Emperor's justice. Sister Dahlia and the other sisters hospitaller are reluctant to let me pass the checkpoint. Apparently my tests are inclusive. Yeah, that's about how I feel. Barbara Stella vouches for me. Not sure when I started thinking of her as a friend. Guess us Palatines gotta stick together. Wonder where the canonist superior is in all of this. Reckon she's either got her feet propped up somewhere with a glass of something pleasant or she's burning someone alive. Don't think that woman has a concept of middle ground. Be Captain Thorne. Surprisingly disappointed by lack of anything going on inside the governess's mansion. Just the usual assassination attempt with the bishop, his wife, and numerous zealots running around fighting what I can presume to be Alpha Legion serfs. Was hoping for more Alpha Marines, but instead they send in fucking serfs. They probably have some sort of backup plan for this, or was the plan just to release gene stealers and their own agents just to mess with us? Fucking Alpha fags. During this course of torching everything, my company gets a call from our commander, Captain Thorn. A large forces of Xenos scum led by a heretical sister shouting about a four-armed emperor is heading to the mansion. Eliminate the Xenos. It was after this call the ground started shaking as if the planet itself wanted its existence to end. What the fuck? When my company positioned ourselves outside, we saw what can make even the most stoic of the Sons of Dawn quake in their power armor. That something was a behemoth horde of gene stealers that could rip Terminator armor to shreds running towards, led by that sister the commander mentioned earlier. By that point, me and my battle brothers just started firing at anything in sight while screaming prayers to the Emperor. My face when I realize what it's like to be the average guardsman. My face when I get the feeling the gene stealers were able to reproduce like Slaanesh hive worlders due to Alpha Legion fuckery. Emperor preserve us. Be Scar the gene stealer. Be quite surprised and happy with the results of reckless tampering with the fabric of time. Seriously. Look at this shit. Pure serene fucking gene stealers. I started this cult like 2 weeks ago. And now we have pure serenes. They grow up so fast, so happy. Seriously though, what the fuck is up with this planet? What happened here that would result in being able to localize time acceleration to a single being or group of beings? I don't even have to even do that myself anymore. A fucking Magus got born a few hours ago and is now an adult. Now he's handling the accelerated birthing and aging. And pure strain grandkids are infecting civilians and fighting battles. Look how big I am now. I'm a full-on patriarch. When did that happen? We haven't actually had a Primus yet. I think the super dedicated sister of battle that I infected is now filling that role. Look at my girl now, very proud. Apparently she's assaulting this world's leader's mansion. She's such a good girl. I hope she knows how proud daddy is of her. Now I'm taking some of my best pure strain grandkids and looking for Sarah. She showed promise, but managed to ingest some naughty substance that's at least temporarily severed her connection to the brood network. She's going to be told not to drink strange liquids without her parent telling her to. Be me, Graffa. The last crasher, the problem child. Be crying. Tears of joy. Bugs be gone.gif. Scampering about this refinery, left the dead. Gave them one last thank you before saying goodbye. That's twice now they've saved me. Still battered and bruised. Still aching from my shot, but no worries there. I can keep going. Belt is warm around me. Like a warm embrace. Feels good.gif. Found a nice place to get a nap. Air ducts within a ruined portion of the refinery. Tight fit for me to get in, the bugs won't be getting in here without me knowing. Need to get some rest. Still have a man to kill. Still probably going to need to get through half the damned Imperium if the alarms are anything to judge by. Not to mention the family is probably not happy I've gotten loose. And darling, have a feeling she wouldn't bite it so easily. But for now, I can get some rest. Wait out whatever is going on out there. Come back stronger tomorrow. Cuddle up with my chain axe. Still smiling when I finally doze off. Be Colonel. After the cleanup, didn't get much time to talk to that Marine Corps. Some of the boys I brought with me said they needed me. Fuck, I'm busy boys. Leave me alone. Something about seeing a massive horde of bugmen chasing a chimera. By the Emperor, there are some guardsmen out there. They need help, but I got nothing to get to them. Well, looks like I can't help them. Sorry lads, hopefully someone gets to you. Move to the few men I have here, like 30 of them. Should we call for the rest of our troops, sir? Fuck. We might need to bring the rest of the lads from the landing site. It would take them a few hours to get here. Yay, make the call. Get the rest of the troops over here and start fortifying these steps. Three firing lines, as usual. If only I had basilisks. My face when. Time to find someone more qualified than me to deal with this shit show. Be Sister Cecilia. Formerly of the Black Sepulchre. Now Brood Sister Primus of the family. And what a glorious family it is. I feel a sense of deep connection to my brothers and sisters in the Brood, be they two, three, or four armed. I especially feel connected to our most glorious father. The four-armed emperor, the scarred king who waits beneath. With his kiss I was welcomed into a greater community. No longer enslaved under the tyranny of nihilistic superiors and their stupid goth poetry. Now I led my brothers and sisters into battle. I led them on towards the governess's mansion. The leaders of this planet will be welcomed to the family. Or they will die. My pure strain brothers charge ahead of me. See ahead space marines showing that they do in fact know fear. and Fear is a group small horde of pure strain gene stealers, each able to shred power armor with its claws, supported by an even larger horde of their lesser brethren, led on by the most glorious daughter of the family, praise a four-armed emperor. Be me, Jara Notorious, Primaris Sergeant. And I, alongside more than two dozen of my fellow brothers from the second company, have just decided to crash this shitty gene stealer party, while wearing aggressor armor, more comfortable than Terminator armor. Hollow. Thousands upon thousands of bolter shells are being spewed out, and basically dismembering infected as well as pure strain cultists, as we jump out of our repulsor tanks. MFW we're launching frag storm grenades at anything that even attempts to look at us funny. Theragonabapakinjana Steeler cooks out off the sub 4 weeks JPEG. Anything that attempts to get to close is turned to paste by the will of our power fists. Tharoths may be broken were a stiltha shields chapter motto. Tell some Praetorian colonel to have his men rally on us as we begin pushing back the plague that are these wretched Xeno collaborators. We shall drive back these foes and let their blood pool at our feet. Wish Olga was here watching this. B Colonel. Some massive marine lads are in the fray yelling at us to come back them up, they are cutting through the mob. I don't know if we should or not, sounds like a bad idea. If only I had basilisks. Fuck it, get the heavy weapon teams set up and get them firing on the horde. Combat the marines. We have artillery firing into the horde, it would be better if we had tanks but the administratum has been ignoring us. I pray these suicidal marines don't die or my firing lines are next, and I love my firing lines. Be me, Jara Notorious. Be leading the charge, slaying hundreds of filthy cultists before they can get within 30 feet of us. Praetorian Colonel comms me. We have artillery firing into the horde, it would be better if we had tanks but the administratum has been ignoring us. Can barely hear him over the sounds of 1,000 bolter rounds per minute, being fired. I merely tell him, not only are we your shields, but we are your tanks, Colonel. Let the broken shields take the brunt of their hatred, as you and your men knock out any nearby armor or heavy vehicles they may have. My repulsor tanks will deal with the rest. There truly is nothing better than protecting those who are innocent, and those whom do not need to fight. Seriously wish Olga was here, watching this. She'd probably be impressed with the amount of purebreds we're killing. Vox Sergeant Irvaran, whom is piloting the repulsor tank, Destiny from within. Tell him to have his tanks fly above the battlefield, and nail those bastards and their armor. Here's where the fun begins. Hollow. Be Sister Cecilia. Be ground leader of Gene Stealer Cult Forces. Four-armed Emperor damn Chad Marines. Brood Brothers can't do anything. Pure Strains can, but their stupid guns are too powerful and rapid fire. Ask Sugar Daddy for anything to help with this situation. He says he'll send up an aberrant. Wait, just an aberrant? I mean, Daddy, I trust you, but just one? He says I'll get it when the big boy gets there. Wait, big boy? Ground begins to shake. A lot. Bursting through the ground, throwing the space marines around, is a fucking massive aberrant gene stealer hybrid. He's about the size of a four-armed Emperor Blessed Carnifex. He has a huge mining laser in the smaller arm, and its two large arms are massive rending claws. He picks up one of the space marines and rips him in half, eating the top half. Daddy contacts me. Apparently the aberrant is named Tiny. The time methods by which hybrids are being produced are apparently producing interesting results occasionally. Blessings of the four-armed emperor. Prayers answered.
So guys, I've got a bit of an announcement, right? So the next Cold Shoulder video that I'll be doing will be the last Cold Shoulder video that I will be doing. Sadly, I know, it's the end of it. It's been going on for a very long time. You guys love it. I fucking love it. But I feel like, honestly, the quality does deteriorate after thread 3. So I'm just going to finish it off on thread 3 and I'll leave all the links, everything, you know, anything you guys can possibly need to know about what happens next, I'll give you all the information that I can, you know, in the next video. But I know it's actually, I'm a bit sad myself that I'm finishing it because, like, you know, I've been doing it for so long now and I really do enjoy it. Like, you know, it's been an amazing series. I think it's got some of the best amateur 40k fanfiction out there by a long shot. Some of it's outstanding. It's on par with the Old Guardsman Party. It's very different to the Old Guardsman Party, but it's still got its own merits, and I love it. But look, it's not going to be completely over, because, like, the next one I'm going to be doing, I'll be doing the last of the thread, and then after that thread in that video, we'll be doing a bit of a Q&A with some of the writers. I've got tried to get in contact with a few of them. Some of them are interested, some of them aren't. I'll just see who I can round up, and we'll just work from there. Leave all your questions in the comments of this video, just so we've got them, you know, just so we know what you guys are interested in, what you want to know. You know, there's so much stuff we could do, you know, and, like, you've been watching for a very long time, and it's just such a good storyline. Honestly, it's so good. Like, you know, to think just, it's just some random 4chan threads, goal plan threads, and they're great, and they were outstanding. But like, I'm sorry for gushing. I'll try and get this going. As I say, comments down below any questions you have for any of the writers. I'll see how I can round up, and we'll just work from there. And hope you guys have enjoyed. And the next one will be out in the near future, I hope. And I'll see you then. All right.
If you haven't already, check out my Redbubble portfolio. You might just find something you like.
Just stop! Just stop it! Stop! No! Just stop it! It's time to stop! It's time to stop, okay? No more! Where the fuck are your parents? Who are your parents? I'm gonna call Child Protective Services! It's time to stop!